everybody. I'm Farron Cousins, and this is The Daily Left, your interactive source for progressive news and commentary. Thanks for joining me. Today's top story, for the third day in a row, Israel has continued bombing Hamas in what has been described as an all-out war between the two. The bombing is in response to an attack by Hamas that left almost 320 Israelis dead. With Israeli tanks idling along the border of the battered Palestinian enclave, the army declared the area a closed military zone, a move that, in the past, has often been followed by ground operations. At least 51 civilians, including children, have died as a result of the Israeli bombardment. In all, the Israeli blitz, unleashed on Saturday in retaliation for ongoing rocket and mortar fire from Gaza, has killed at least 312 Palestinians and wounded more than 1,400 others. Gaza has remained on the defensive, firing 40 rockets into Israel so far today. The UN Security Council is urging an immediate end to all military activities in the Gaza Strip and has called on the parties to address the humanitarian crisis in the territory. In a rare example of council unity over the divisive issue of Gaza, the text was approved after 5 hours of closed-door consultations called by Libya, the lone Arab member on the council, in response to the Israeli air raids. Diplomats said a compromise statement initially put forward by Russia was watered down at the urging of the United States. The final text approved by consensus mentions neither Israel nor the Islamist movement Hamas by name. And speaking of war zones, the corporate-controlled media is showing that real news doesn't really matter, and three of the major networks have pulled their full-time correspondents from Iraq. According to former Baghdad bureau chief for CNN, the war zone has gone on longer than most news outlets had anticipated, and they no longer have the appetite for it. At the same time that news organizations are trimming in Iraq, the television networks are trying to add news people in Afghanistan and Pakistan, with expectations that the Obama administration will focus on the conflict there. ABC, CBS, and NBC have all declined to speak on the record about their news coverage decisions, but representatives for the networks emphasized that they would continue to cover the war and said the staff adjustments reflected the evolution of the conflict in Iraq from a story primarily about violence to one about reconstruction and politics. Since the start of the war, the media has done a less than poor job of covering what is really happening on the ground in Iraq. Pulling reporters from the country won't really change their coverage, since they never reported the truth anyway. But maybe they'll start telling us what's really going on in Afghanistan, but I wouldn't hold my breath waiting for that to happen.
You can't handle the truth!
And also today, Karl Rove made a startling assumption over the weekend, proclaiming that historians will look back on President George W. Bush with a kind eye. Rove said that Bush would end up like Harry Truman, who left office being very unpopular, but gained back some approval a few years later. But in all fairness to Truman, he didn't lie the American people into an endless war and preside over one of the most corrupt administrations in history. He also didn't have anyone as evil as Rove telling him how to run the country either. Rove joins outgoing Secretary of State Condoleezza Rice and First Lady Laura Bush in making the media rounds over the weekend, propping up their image of the Commander-in-Chief. Bush is set to leave office, having secured the record for lowest presidential approval rating in history, which hit 19% in both February 2008 and again in September 2008. He also set the highest disapproval rating at 76% in September of this year.
Thank you. Now watch this drive.
That's it for today, but don't forget to check out our blog at ringoffireradio.com. I'm Farron Cousins, and thanks for watching Go Left TV, Citizens Media on the Rise.